In this video, I'll show you how to make a teleporter pad in Roblox Studio. Teleporter pads allow players to quickly move around the game. You can set up two pads so that when you step on pad 1, you instantly teleport to pad 2 and vice versa. Firstly, inside the Roblox Studio, click on the Home tab and insert twopParts. Name the parts pad 1 and pad 2. Then select both parts in the Explorer, set their size to 4x1x4, and set the colour of each pad so that we can tell the difference between them. I'm going to drag the teleporter pads away from each other so that we can notice the teleporting. Next, insert a script into pad 1. In this script, let's create a variable to hold the path to the other pad which we will be teleported to. Write local pad equals game.workspace.pad2. We now have a reference to the other pad. Next, let's create a touched event, which will fire and execute code when the user touches our pad. Write script.parent.touched:connect, and then we'll have an opening bracket. Inside of there, we'll put function, and we'll have another pair of brackets, and then we'll drop a line and make sure that you've got an end with a closing bracket. Now inside our second pair of brackets, let's insert an argument called hit. The hit inside of the bracket, our argument, will be the object which touches our teleporter pad. This will likely be one of our players' body parts. We'll need to check this to make sure only players get teleported, since other blocks can touch our teleporter as well. Let's create a variable to store the result of a function call to check if this object's parent is indeed a player character, since body parts are stored within a character model. Write local player equals game.players:getPlayerFromCharacter, and in brackets write hit.parent. Now this variable will either be true or false, and it tells us whether there is an actual player touching our brick. Next, let's write a simple if statement to check this. Write if player, then drop a line, make sure you've got an end. Inside of this if statement, let's check to make sure they're not currently teleporting. We need to do this to prevent the player from being teleported back and forth constantly. Before we do that, let's create a value which we can store in the player's character to hold a true or false value on whether the player is currently teleporting on a pad. Click on the arrow next to Start a Player in the Explorer panel to expand this service. Then, inside Start a Character Scripts, click on the plus icon or right click and select Insert Object. Search for a bool value and select it. Then, select the bool value, and in the Properties window, which you can access by pressing View in the ribbon menu, edit the name property to Currently Teleporting. Back in our script, let's create a variable for this value which we just created so we can keep a reference to it. Write local currently teleporting equals player.character:findFirstChildCurrentlyTeleporting. Since the currently teleporting value might not be in our player for some reason, we can do a quick check to ensure the script only continues if the value is present. Write, if not currently teleporting, then return end. Now let's check the value of our currently teleporting bool value by writing, if not currently teleporting dot value, then drop a line and end. Now inside this second if statement, let's set the currently teleporting value to true for 3 seconds so that the player can't teleport back to the origin pad until the cooldown is over. Write currently teleporting dot value equals true. Let's write a line of code to teleport the player to the pad we referenced at the start of the script. Write player.character.humanoidRootPart.cFrame equals pad.cFrame plus vector3.new, and in brackets, write 0, 5, 0. Drop a line and write wait, and then in brackets, 3. Then after the cooldown of 3 seconds, let's set the currently teleporting value back to false. Write currently teleporting dot value equals false. Now let's test our first pad to make sure it works. I'm going to close our script and then I'll click on the home tab and select play solo. Then walk over to pad 1. You should be teleported to pad 2. If the pad doesn't work, check the output window by clicking on the view tab and selecting output. This should log any error messages from your code if there are any. Since we've so far only coded one pad, make sure that you're walking over the right one. Next, let's script our second pad to send users back to the original one. I'm going to copy the script from pad 1 by selecting it, right-clicking and choosing copy. Then I'm going to select pad 2 in the Explorer window, right-click on it and choose paste into. Then in the pad 2 script, I'm going to change the pad variable to instead reference pad 1. Now I'm going to test the game again, and as you can see, both my teleporter pads are now working.